Number 13. Recently, Kim Carnes told us she once acted in a movie called Come On, Let's Live a Little, which she described as a beach movie set around a swimming pool. Sometime later, she finally saw the movie at a drive-in, and it convinced her to give up her acting career. Kim said, "I was horrible, awful. There was one scene where I was dancing, and a dancer I'm not," end of quote. But a singer she is. Here's Kim Carnes at number 13 with More Love. Kim Carnes on American Top 40, eighth week on the chart, now at number 13, moving up a notch with More Love. Kisses, 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 coast to coast. American Top 40. American Top 40 is heard in the 50 states and around the world every week on great radio stations like WKIK, Leonardtown, Maryland, WKNY, Kingston, New York, and commercial radio, Hong Kong. This week, Kim Carnes climbs a notch to number 12 with her first solo hit, More Love. More Love by Kim Carnes. You know, over the years, we've spoken to some artists who learned how to be singers and others who swear they were born to be singers, like Kim Carnes, who recently told us, quote, "Nothing came from my family or from anyone that I knew. I always sang. As far back as I can remember, I knew I was going to be a singer. It must have been born in me." At number 28, here's born singer Kim Carnes with Draw the Cards. Kim Carnes at number 28, second week in a row, fifth week on the chart with Draw of the Cards. Casey's Coast to Coast. Well, now on American Top 40, we're up to the current hit by a singer who began her career wide-eyed and innocent and grew up fast in 6 months. This is the story of what happened to 36-year-old singer and songwriter Kim Carnes when she was just starting her career. Kim began writing songs when she was a little girl growing up in Pasadena. Her dream was to become a singer. By the time she was in her teens, she decided that the thing to do was to record a demo tape to play for record companies. And she found a studio run by a man who produced the demo tape for her and seemed very impressed with her talent. And it didn't hurt that Kim's a pretty blonde. He said that if she'd sign an exclusive managerial contract with him, he'd turn her into a star in just 6 months. Well, Kim admits that she was a little naive, and she signed with the man. Not long after, he told Kim he had to go away to Australia on business, but he'd get started on her career as soon as he got back. So Kim waited, and waited, and waited. And finally, after 6 months, she went back to the studio to find out what was going on with her promised stardom. But there was a new sign on the recording studio. It said, "Travel Agency." And there, behind a desk, with colorful travel posters all around, was the record producer and artist's manager who had promised to make her a star. Now, he was a travel agent. Kim says she was lucky. Her career could have been messed up by the way she jumped into that contract. Fortunately, all it cost her was 6 months of dreams. And it taught her plenty. This week, Kim Carnes is in our countdown with her sixth Top 40 hit. At number 29, here's Voyeur. Kim Carnes' third week on American Top 40, the title song from her LP, Voyeur, at number 29, as the countdown continues. It's from coast to coast. Now we're up to one of those many stories about making it in show business, about paying your dues. This is the dues-paying story that singing star and songwriter Kim Carnes told to us. Back in the early 1970s, Kim and her husband, Dave Ellingson, who's also a songwriter, were struggling to get known. And they would take any job that allowed them to try out their songs on a live audience. So they wound up playing a lot of small clubs up and down the West Coast. The strangest club she ever played, she said, was a beachfront hangout in Manhattan Beach near Los Angeles. The place had a gimmick. Musicians would perform sitting in a rowboat mounted on top of a piano. And rowdy customers would not be discouraged from throwing pretzels, peanuts, and small change into the boat. This was okay with Kim and Dave. Okay until one night after a big football game, when the customers decided to swamp the boat with pitchers of beer. Kim Carnes told us she left the club that night soaked to the skin and smelling like a brewery. Even her guitar was full of beer. Kim left that place and never went back. These days, the rowboat's behind her, and it's been smooth sailing for Kim Carnes. Here she is, part of a vocal trio in our countdown at number 36. Kenny Rogers, Kim Carnes, and James Ingram with What About Me? Kenny Rogers with Kim Carnes and James Ingram. At number 36, falling three notches this week on American Top 40 with What About Me?
The hits from coast to coast.
The number two song of the 1980s sounded a lot different when the singer first heard the original. That was recorded by Jackie DeShannon. Listen.
Her hair is her logo. She's got Bette Davis eyes.
Does that sound like an 80s hit? Well, the song was offered to singer Kim Carnes.
The song was 7 or 8 years old, so the treatment was dated. And when we started rehearsing for that album, we took a good 3 or 4 days trying to figure out what to do with it. And Bill Como, my keyboard player, sat over in the corner with his prophet, and he's the one who came up with the sound of that record, with the lick. And once he played that for us, everybody knew beyond a shadow that was the way to do the song.
And how right they were. In 1981, it was a summer smash, spending 5 weeks at number one, falling down to number two, then returning to number one for 4 more weeks. How about that? Here's the second biggest hit of the 80s by Kim Carnes, Bette Davis Eyes.
When she snows you.
9 weeks at number one, Bette Davis Eyes by Kim Carnes. The singer born in Hollywood, singing about a woman with eyes like a Hollywood star. She has the second biggest hit of the 1980s.
The hits from coast to coast.